I just drew gooden today, and I'm going to paint him. First, I'm going to paint his background. But first, I was going to do the shirt first, but then looking to the picture right now, I feel like it's more appropriate to do the background first. What I'm using now is himi miya gouache, and these are pencils, so I'm careful not to go over the lines or it will smudge. Okay, that's too strong. Yeah, I drew him while I was on a class because I was really bored, and yeah, it's just a thing to keep me occupied. So here's my drawing of him. At first I was not going to color it, but then I want to color it. The colors on this photo is pretty cool, so I'd like to color him. I'm adding water constantly because I'm going to do a washed out version first with these colors. I don't think I will focus on the background so much because it feels like a distraction to the whole composition if I'm going to render the whole background. But yeah, I'm just thinking about the underpainting first, just not keeping it too bright or too vibrant. Going to add some oranges on his hands because I feel like on the reference picture the lighting shows some orange on his hands, so I'm gonna add that as well. But also gonna add some orange on his face. One of the first times I ever drawn a YouTuber, wait, well, also paint them. I also did one for Struthless. Yeah, that's what I did before. I'm adding some depths on some areas, like his fingers here. Yeah, I'm not really used to speaking and also painting at the same time. This is an orange one, so I probably should mix a color for it. Probably some red and some yellow. But it's not going to be vibrant as much. His lips are pinkish with some white, so I'm going to do that color with, could have gone with red. Yeah, this is pretty much his lip color. Going to add that in. That looks like a lipstick, so I don't know if I'm going with that route ever again. Color here, it does not look the same, so I'm going to add some different blue. It's probably a cerulean blue. It's kind of nice. I'm just going to do this, and I'm going to add layers. I can't see the whole text on his t-shirt, so I'm not going to add it here. The only thing I can read is what? Corrupt this marriage or softball? What? So random. Just like his humor. I'm gonna add some saturation here. What I really don't like about pencils and then adding over a watercolor on them is it smudges, and I don't know, it doesn't look quite as good, but I'm just sketching him, so no worries. Then I'm going to use the green one, this green one, for his hair. Yeah, that's, I think that's a perfect color. Oh no, I'm adding some yellow. I think that's more accurate. No, I don't think that's accurate. I'm going to add some white in there just to soften it up, especially these lower parts, because yeah. And his eyes are like a gray, a bluish gray. I can't quite understand the color on his eyes because the lighting is not that good for his eyes. But I really think the green hair is suiting his face more. Yeah, I think that's really good. Then I'm going to add some of this in here to make it look cohesive. Now adding some colors that I've used to the shadows. Right now it's looking a little too blonde, so I'm going to add something on this part, like probably a blush, even though it doesn't look like he has blush on his face. Going to also add it here and probably some here. I'm just looking at the reference and seeing where those oranges look vibrant the most. I'm just going to apply it here, and I can even them out because this is gouache and it's water soluble, so it doesn't matter. So yeah, about Drew, I think he was the first commentary he was the first commentary YouTuber that I've ever seen on YouTube. So I guess that's why I'm pretty much loyal for his humor, and I don't know, he's just the funniest of them all. So yeah, I even added him on my YouTuber recommendations. His comedy is just pretty diverse for me, like it doesn't stick on just one thing. It's random, just like me. I quite do things randomly. I don't stick on one regimen for like a month. I think every time that I paint his face, it becomes more not like him. I think I'm messing up his face there, and I'm going to blend this in, but I think this is too much, so I'm going to do this. Let's add some white so it won't look as transparent. Here, this part is kind of more opaque than this one. So that's how I use my gouache. I don't want it to be so detailed, but I'm still focusing on how the reference picture looks. Let's add some water in here so that I can scatter this part. So as you can see in this part, there's some shadows, and I'm going to define them by adding a darker color, and also this part, but I see it more as a faded one, so I'm just gonna add it like this so I can blend it out later. By then I'm going to add some white in here and some blue again, just so and some textures, adding some bluer sections on the top because of how the reference picture folds. His shirt folds here on the reference picture, and also I'm going to add some textures in this area just so you can see some of the folds on his shirt, but just very subtle, not too much of a big deal. Okay, I think that's a pretty good rendering of the shirt, but I'm going to let it simmer down and I'm going to adjust the orange hat first. It will look more desaturated because it's in the shadow part of the cup and it's not too orange. So I'm going to add it here. It's going to do different things in here. On his mouth, going to add some, I don't know, man. This doesn't look good. Yeah, I think I need to clean up my brush. Oh no, I peed here. Bro, what? Anyways, let's go back here and just finish the painting. Yeah, now I just washed my watercolor brush and I'm going to focus more on the details of his face. As you can see here, he's got glasses, so I'm just gonna add some white and some orange here. Oh, it doesn't quite show. Probably add highlights later. But right now, I'm just marking the glass so that I won't forget that he has glasses here. And I'm just going to even out his teeth. I see some pinks in his eyes. White here. I'm going to add it here. And some oranges on his face. I can see some violet in here. Going to add some violet for the shadow. That looks so good. And also add it here to define some of his facial features. If you want to make your piece cohesive, I saw this in a YouTube video that you should use the colors in all sorts of places. Well, not just sorts of places, but like how it can make sense. Like, I'm using this color violet on the shadows part of his skin. Like, I'm not just using it all over the place, trying to make it look more cohesive. It's so hard to draw someone on glasses, especially because I don't use it for his eyebrows. He still looks like blue. Yeah, so I can't get the effect where the glasses makes the eyes smaller than usual. So I'm not gonna bother his black ring here. I could add the microphone here, but I don't think it will look nice overall on this composition. So I'm not gonna bother to add the microphone. Add this one. No. No way. This is a disaster. But let's be back again with this one. Wish me luck. I hope that this will look good. I don't think it looks good. I'm just going to finalize this one. Maybe I'll just add this with this color. Oh, that looks so good. I'm just going to sketch. Why does this look like Among Us? It's weird. Yeah, the lettering is quite absurd, but I don't care anymore. That looks good, and I'm going to clean all this mess. I'm not gonna lie. Oh my! I have to get that. Because I was talking and drawing for the whole time, I can't quite figure out anything else. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed this vid of me drawing Drew on his biggest vid. And yeah, that's about it. Bye.